Good afternoon. Congratulations to the graduates, and I want to give my heartfelt thanks to this illustrious faculty and staff for inviting me to participate in this truly joyous celebration. No matter where you come from, what nation or religion, no matter your age or life experience, to fulfill the dreams of the heart is the most sought after goal. I'm not sure where the dreams come from, but I can guess the why. We each have an evolutionary impulse to grow, to produce, to survive. And that impulse, those dreams are why we're here today. Did you choose this moment when you were a child? Is it God-given? Was the lust for educational achievement instilled in you by others in your life? Maybe for some of you, the choice was made after desperate times forced you to reconsider your life's path. Maybe a dream that still lies beyond this moment brought you to AIU as a necessary step to get to where you're going. Whatever the case may be, and I'm sure that there are as many versions of this story as there are graduates today in this room and elsewhere. Whatever the case may be, you are here. You have done it. Through sacrifice, hard work, purposefulness, perseverance, you are sitting in the seat of your choosing. This is the moment you dreamed of. Today, each one of you represents a dream fulfilled. I'd like you to remember that at this very moment, as we revel in your accomplishments at AIU here at Navy Pier, there are places in our nation and in our world that are enduring utter isolation, annihilation, destruction, ignorance, and violence. From climate change to poverty and violence here at home, our borders in Texas, little girls abducted in Nigeria, people slaughtered in the Middle East, lives lost in the Ukraine. We're living in a world that needs the educated more than ever before. Whatever impulse brought you to this place, to better yourself, to better the life of your family, to live a life filled with achievement, to make your parents and grandparents, your children proud, I'm here to tell you that your dreams are not just your own. Your dreams are so much bigger than you, far greater than you can even imagine. They're meant to be shared. Knowing this will be the key to your success. Knowing this will build all of the qualities you need to be successful so that you can move forward from dream to greater dream. Knowing that your dream is larger than yourself, it's been my experience, it'll give you three really important things. It'll bolster your determination, making you strong enough to weather the greatest winds. It will naturally align you with people who have the same goals. Knowing that your dream is larger than you will also engage your creativity and enable you to adapt when necessary. When you realize that your dream is bigger than yourself, your goals become greater. A determination begins to build such that you marvel at the person you've become. Suddenly, a C+ passing grade isn't good enough. Only an A will do. Maybe B+. The point is, passing won't do. I don't like this idea of passing, of getting by. You know, not revealing your true self, just doing enough. When that's no longer good enough or satisfying, you start to reach higher. And when you do, it becomes more difficult. You're no longer walking or strolling, you're climbing. And you have to muster all your strength, everything you have inside of you, to push through and make it to the finish line. And that's what I'm sure each of you has already done. In my own journey, I wondered why things became more difficult when I graduated from Harvard. I worked hard when I was a little girl, but I didn't really experience struggle until after I graduated. And it took me some time to understand why. I had turned down parts that didn't tell stories that I believed in. I couldn't help it. C+ wasn't good enough. I remember before I started my production company to tell those new stories, I remember actually telling my sister over the phone, literally, I can't just pass. I can't pander. I didn't go to school for that. The bar had been raised, and because it has, it went from easy to difficult. At first, I couldn't understand why. But then I heard a story that gave me a lot of strength that I want to share with you. It's a story of the butterfly and the moth. Did you know that the metamorphosis, in order for it to truly take place, you can never cut a cocoon or a chrysalis open. You might see the new creature underneath wiggling and struggling to get out, but if you cut it open to help it, it will never fly. In order to fly, it has to break through the cocoon on its own. It's the struggle beneath, the difficulty. That's the activity that makes its wings strong enough to catch the wind. And it takes a great cause, a belief not only in oneself, a belief in a sort of evolution in one's purpose, one's contribution, your contribution, to build enough strength and determination to catch the wind. Think of how you felt when you first applied to AIU. I invite you to travel back in time as best as you can and see that younger man or woman. Think of the courage it took to believe in a future that did not yet exist. That others may have tried to warn you against, that you made a leap of faith to pursue. I promise that your career will be exponentially more fulfilling if you look out onto your future with the same curiosity, the same courage. Imagine wildly all the things that may come to pass, all of the ways you can contribute. Don't look at your employment as your resting place. If you remember that the dream is bigger than you, so much more than what's right in front of you will be possible. Even better, you'll make friends and allies, as I'm sure you already have, who understand this truth as well. And nothing is more powerful or more world-changing than people coming together who have aligned purposes. It's impossible to know the full extent and breadth of the dream that's inside of you. Sometimes it's hard to know if the choices that you're making are right. This is especially true if you're on a road built by dreams and hard work. It means that it's the road less traveled. Even worse, there's sometimes roadblocks. Changes in management, macroeconomic changes in your industry, which you're bound to experience because our world is changing so rapidly. But be creative, be adaptable. Life has a beautiful way of evolving us, as us and through us, if we understand that there is more to work than our own survival and achievement. It's important to keep your mind and heart as open as it is right now on this day. And remember that there's always possibility for those who believe in possibility. Imagination is the heart of creativity, and my hope for you is that you never let work get in the way of your creativity and evolution. My parents instilled in me that to whom much is given, much is expected. And yes, you worked your butt off for this degree. But be grateful for what you've learned here at AIU. Be grateful for the incredible peers you've gotten to know. They will be your allies. Be grateful for the incredible professors and teachers that were there when you needed help. Be grateful for the nights and days that seemed endless when you thought you wouldn't make a deadline or pass a course. When you thought you wouldn't be able to pay your tuition that semester. Be grateful for the hard work and struggle that delivered you to this place. It built your determination. It built your courage. It built your creativity. And with those qualities, you can change anything you want. Yourself, your workplace, your community, and your world. Be grateful enough to share everything that you've learned. I remember my own graduation day years ago. I just went to my 10-year reunion. It poured down on campus. Wasn't a beautiful day like it is here at Navy Pier. Torrential rains almost stopped the promenade of graduates marching through the gates of Harvard Yard. We wondered if we would get the moment that we all had worked so hard for, suffered through so much to achieve, because Harvard wasn't prepared for the rain. Apparently, it had been 75 years since it had ever rained on a graduation day at Harvard. I am the first generation in my family to be born here in the United States. My mom is from Panama, my father's from Trinidad. They came here separately to this country to live a better life, and they were determined that we understood how essential education is. And to prove it, every year we covered our public school textbooks in brown paper bags and book covers with the names of the best colleges scrawled across the front. And the brainwashing worked. All of my sisters are graduates. And with that background, there was no way that I was not going to walk on my graduation day. There could have been a tornado warning. We all did. I remember my mortarboard and gown. We were drenched, black dye dripping down my friends' faces and my own. Our dresses and suits underneath were stained still to this day with that black dye. But when I look back on it, I see how ironic that was. Because beneath the gleam, it was supposed to be gleaming, but beneath the gleam, we were actually drenched through. Beneath that aura of achievement and truth, that the dreams of so many were being fulfilled at that moment, beneath that lied an even deeper truth. We were all so unsure of what life on the other side was going to be like. What happens when you climb the mountain, when the ceremony has ended, when the excitement the months before leading up to this blessed event has ebbed? Where does one find herself or himself when you realize that this moment is not actually the destination? I urge you to recognize that the metamorphosis you've undergone was the real reason for the journey you decided to undertake years ago. The dream of the heart is always one of expansion. I look back and I see how fitting it was that my cap and gown were drenched from rain. That the bright red scandalous dress my mom bought me that day for my special occasion was dyed with black ink. That is the day that I emerged, a new creature. Armed with all that I had learned and experienced along the way, prepared to make a lasting impression on the world, a contribution to my community, prepared to truly care for my loved ones and my friends and my family, I want you to always remember that your achievements are meant to be shared. In sharing your determination, in sharing your courage and your creativity, you are truly living the dream of the Most High human heart. You will be asked many times to make pivotal choices. When it happens, remember the pride in your family's faces today. Remember the love that surrounds you and the friendships that you've made. Remember the climb and the achievement that you feel right now. Remember that the dream is what's to be shared. The dreamer that became the graduate who chose this seat on this day. Thank you so much.